More than $1 million of that money the governor is restoring will go to the Portland School District. But the superintendent is still proposing some significant cuts. Jim Morse outlined his budget plan tonight with more than 100 teachers listening in, dozens of whom could lose their jobs. News 8's Jackie Couture joins us now with the details. Jackie?
Well, Steve, under that plan rolled out today from Augusta, the Portland School District would gain back about $1.3 million in state aid. Still with that, though, they face a $5 million shortfall, and that means cuts to programs and layoffs. It was standing room only at tonight's Portland School Committee meeting. More than 100 people, mostly teachers, listened in as Superintendent Dr. James Morse presented his budget. The $89.3 million proposal includes a 2.5% increase in taxes, plus more than 80 positions would be cut. That's mostly teachers and ed techs. It would also mean cuts to middle school sports. They're working on a partnership so kids could continue to play, but it would be with the city's recreation department and other community organizations. Also, freshman sports would be eliminated. Dr. James Morse says the budget is committed to the students' education, and he recognizes that the cuts hurt.
Looking at, you know, staff members who have put their heart and soul in their teaching profession, they're incredible with kids, and at the same time you're saying, I don't have the money to be able to sustain you as an employee. That's a tragedy.
Job losses and changes in working conditions and all those things, those are very tough things on the people, you know, who those impact on too. So we really think we're looking for the school committee to find a better balance between tough decisions that are not just staff.
You just heard there from Gary Vines. He's a member of the Portland Education Association, which basically represents all the teachers. Vines says they see the system as top-heavy and would like to see more administrative cuts, not at the level so close to students. They'll be proposing that at public hearings. And, of course, now it's in the school committee's hands. That means they want to hear from you, from teachers, parents, and students before they make any final decisions. A public hearing's been set for March 8th. That's, in fact, next Monday at the Hall School Gymnasium. In the studio, Jackie Couture, News 8.